Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to my another video, and in this video we are going to talk about microservices and event driven design pattern. Okay, so you might have already heard about event driven design pattern, where you are raising an event and you are creating a producer and consumer kind of scenarios where you are able to achieve the decoupling between services. So this is like a booking platform we are building. Okay, there is a API gateway we have, and there are different microservices. Like here it is a booking service, okay, then it is talking to a payment service. And finally, once the payment is done, you are sending a notification to the user, okay, your ticket has been booked for this particular movie. So what is the problem with the current architecture if you are trying to build it with a simple REST APIs, okay? This is API gateway, user will come, will do the booking. Once booking is done, it will ask you the payment page, payment APIs, payments microservice will talk to the banking service APIs. And once banking, this is done, then you will actually send a notification to particular. You will talk to a particular microservice to send a notification either through mail and messages and all, right? So this is your notification service. The only problem which we see with the current architecture is everything is synchronous communication, request and reply. If something goes down, you don't have a record of transaction, what has happened to this particular. You did the booking, everything was correct, even the payment was done, but you didn't receive a message through the notification service. So in these cases where you want reliable communication happening between different services, you have to introduce these messaging protocols, like messaging services. So what we need to do is we will just introduce wherever we need, we see, okay, there is a need of asynchronous communication, okay, and reliable delivery of message. We can introduce these messaging queues platform, like we have SQS and we have like RabbitMQs and all. So I will just take an example of RabbitMQ. So this is our payment microservice. Okay, I am doing booking. Now what I will do is I will put the SQS queues here, and payment microservice is nothing but it is now a booking service is now producer. Once booking is done, it will send a message with some payload. Okay, this is the message and this is what I'm sending. Okay, it is in the definition, this is called event. So let's say there is a message. Okay, it will just create a message and it will send it to you can say RabbitMQ. Let's call it as a RabbitMQ, which is using AMQP protocol. Okay, you send a message. Now there is a producer, right? Producer will read this message, okay, and it will just talk to the banking service APIs. There is, let's say there is a banking service API, one common API gateway, payment gateway we have. This can be a banking service, or you are using some kind of a third party payment provider like PayU or other service, right? So RabbitMQ, now why there is a need of RabbitMQ here? You are a producer and payment service is actually a consumer. So consider that the payment APIs from third party provider is down, they are not responding. If you consider, if you are putting this in the HTTP protocol where you just have a request reply mechanism, in that case there will be, if there is a failure from the payment services, your transaction is gone, you didn't receive a notification and your transaction is broken, you will not even know what need to be done. So to reliable delivery of message, we introduce RabbitMQ. You produce it, produce the booking ticket for the payment. Now payment microservice will receive that message. Until unless you receive a 200 or some kind of a success from the payment APIs, banking APIs, till then we will have to maintain this message in the RabbitMQ. Receive the message. If you got the 200, acknowledge RabbitMQ. Okay, I did the successful processing for this event. Now you can get rid of it. You can remove that message. So payment consumer will need to notify RabbitMQ. Okay, things are good, you can delete this message. But if you keep receiving the failures, consumer, there can be a logic where you can do a 3 or 4 times retry of this particular message, and this particular message will be maintained in the MQs until unless you see the successful delivery. Same thing can happen with this. Once your booking is done, right, you can actually put some kind of MQs for delivering different kind of messages. Here this is a notification service. It will be talking to some kind of a Twilio or email service. What if your email service is down and user is not receiving message, right? Like banking OTPs, banking emails and all which we are receiving. So if email service is down, notification service is considering as a consumer will receive this message. Now it is also become a producer. It will just, it is now acting as a MQ client. It will just send a message to the exchange, RabbitMQ exchange, and notification service will just get the message and will deliver it to the email service. What if email service is down? Same scenario will be here. It will maintain the record of it, and once the service is up after some retries, it will be able to deliver it. And there is a dead letter queues and all. So RabbitMQ will still keep the record if there are failures. So that is the guarantee of delivery of message over the time. It's not like, okay, you have a 60 seconds HTTP timeout and you have to send it by then. These are asynchronous transactions, and in all the banking services works on these event driven design patterns somehow. Some or another way, there is a Kafka, RabbitMQ, SQS are involved in their transactional processings, because these all are asynchronous tasks which will happen over the time. You can't wait. So what you do is you create a producer. This is my producer, and you create a consumer for it. Okay, consumer will be another microservice. This is producer, and there will be a consumer. Producer will produce the message. Once something has happened, like once the payment has been successful, you wanted to send an event or something, or you see some particular trade has been received. Now you are sending this to the MQs. There may be a different kind of MQs, RabbitMQ, Kafka, SQS, and this is your consumer, and this is your producer. So it is sending a message based on some particular event, like payment has already been succeeded. Producer will produce some kind of a message to the MQs, okay, send a notification. Or if some kind of a trade has arrived, do the transaction, right? Some particular banking trade has arrived from a particular user, particular client. Now do the transaction. It will just post it to the MQs. Consumer will take care of doing that transaction, right? Only the responsibility of MQ is to keep that message alive until unless the consumer is able to process that successfully through the other services. Okay, and you have these different kind of a retry mechanism. What it is doing is it is doing a decoupling between producer and consumer. Consumer doesn't know about producer, and there can be multiple consumers or multiple producer on the same stream. Okay, now what we will do is we have a setup of RabbitMQ. We will use the RabbitMQ container, and we will try to orchestrate it through the Docker Compose.